This is a frequently asked question in your probability and statistics course, and it's in module 1. So I'd like to go over this problem with you. It is on constructing a frequency distribution, and here we're asked to use 5 classes. Here is the data that we're given. Notice this is raw data, and that the number of data is 20, so we have 20 data values. What we want to do to begin, the easiest way to handle this type of problem is to go ahead and sort all of the data from smallest to largest. You can do this using your calculator, and I'll just go over that briefly. So you can get your TI-83 or TI-84 and use the sort function on the calculator. So here is my calculator, and I'll show you how to do this briefly. So you'll hit your stat button and leave it on the edit screen and enter all of the raw data in list 1. Now I've already done this, so just go ahead and put all of your raw data in list 1. Then hit stat again, go down to sort A, that's number 2, hit enter, and then tell the calculator you want to sort list 1. So you hit second, list 1, enter. When you go back to the edit screen, so hit stat, leave it on edit, and see how all of this data is sorted from smallest to largest. Now I've already done this to save time. And here is the data sorted from smallest to largest. The next thing we want to do is find the class width. To find the class width, you take your maximum data value and subtract the minimum data value and divide that by the number of classes. So here, our largest data value is 19, and our smallest data value is 0. And we were told to use 5 classes. So 19 minus 0 divided by 5 turns out to be 3.8. So we're going to go up to the next whole number, which is 4, and our class width is 4. I want to make a remark here that this is not rounding. You're going up to the next whole number always. Even if this was 3.2, you would use 4 as your class width. Even if this had been 3, you would go to 4 for your class width. All right, let's look at how to construct the frequency distribution table. Now, let's begin with the classes. So, you always begin your first class with your smallest data value. Now, notice that I have written all of these lower limits in red. There's a reason I did that. I want to show an easier way to find these lower limits simply by listing all of your lower limits first. If your lowest data value is 0 and your class width is 4, then your next lower limit will be the sum of this lower limit plus the class width, and that takes you to 4. I do that again. 4 plus 4 is 8. 8 plus 4 is 12. 12 plus 4 is 16. So you can start by listing out all of your lower class limits first. That's just an easier, quicker way to do this. Now to get your upper limits, you simply subtract 1 from the next class's lower limit and put it in the previous class's upper limit. So 4 minus 1 is 3. 8 minus 1 is 7. 12 minus 1 is 11. 16 minus 1 is 15. Now, if we had had another class here, we would have added 4 to 16 to get 20, and 20 minus 1 is 19. Okay, so that's how you find your class limits. Now let's look at tallying out the frequencies. So now that the data is sorted from smallest to largest, it makes it much easier to just tally off how many data fall within each class. So the first class is between 0 and 3. So we can just count the number of data that are between 0 and 3. So I can count 1, 2, 3. So there are 3 data in that class. The number of data between 4 and 7, we can count. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 data. So I've written that down already. And then how many data are between 8 and 11? There's 1, 2. I've written that down. How many data are between 12 and 15? Well, there's just one. It's this one. And then the last class, how many data are between 16 and 19? Well, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so that's how you find all the frequencies for each class. The next thing we want to do is locate the midpoints for each class. So to find the midpoint, you take the sum of the class limit and divide by 2. So I've already done this, and to save time, I'll just say, you know, pause this and write it down if you'd like, but just know that all of these are found by taking the sum of the class limits, dividing by 2. So I did that for each one. To find your relative frequencies, you look at the frequency of the class and divide by the total number of data. We had 20 data values. So 3 divided by 20 is 0.15. 9 divided by 20 is 0.45, and so on. Now, to find your cumulative frequencies, you start with the first class and you see how many data were used in the first class. There was 3. By the time you get to the next class, we've used 9 more data values. So we add 9 to 3 and get 12. In the next class, we have 2 more data values that we've used. So we add 2 to 12 and we get 14, and so on. Now, this last entry should always be the total number of data. I hope this example helps. Good luck, everyone.